Welcome to Betty's Kitchen. Today we're going to start in a little bit different way. I have this big bag up here on the counter, and this represents a gift that was sent to me a couple of weeks ago. Once it got opened, it looked like this. I decided to go another level. I think this is the way it needs to be. And there you have the gift. What it holds is just wonderful. And it's something I had never heard of. The name of it is given right here, preserved flower. I think a red rose is just perfect for me. I really love it. And I think I'll tell you who sent it to me. It is Alan Kent Fisher, and I want to say thank you so much for this wonderful gift. And also, part of the gift was the message in the ribbon: love is eternal. So I thought that Alan probably was thinking of me and what I've been through in the past 5 years, and wanting to say, you know, something that is not with you right at this moment is not gone. It's eternal. So thank you so much. It's a perfect gift for me. Right now, I keep it right across from me where I'm sitting on the sofa watching TV a lot, and it's where I can see it all the time. So I really love it, and I appreciate you doing this. And Alan has sent me things before. I still have the apron. It's beautiful and it's personalized to Betty's Kitchen. He has sent me books. He sent me numerous cards and words of inspiration and appreciation. And I really thank you for that, Alan. Thanks for everything. This is wonderful. The food item that we're going to make today is light chocolate cheesecake. Now, I made cheesecake already, and it was lemon cheesecake, so I thought I would go ahead and give you the chocolate version. So it's a light cheesecake, and it's chocolate flavored, and it's going to have a sort of a fake crust like we did last time. I'm going to use walnuts. These are walnut pieces. And in order to use them as the crust, we need to spray. And I do want to point out the pan that has the clamp that we usually call the springform pan. I used an old one from the home where I grew up last time when I made the light lemon cheesecake. And I thought I would update you a bit, so we'll spray. This happens to be an olive oil spray. So we have our spraying out of the way, and I'm going to introduce 1/2 cup of nuts, which you can get nut pieces like this, or you can chop nuts yourself. And they don't have to be walnuts. These are, but pecans are really great. The purpose is to make you feel like you have a crust, and that's why we can call this light. Everything has been analyzed to see if we can make a substitution that's going to save a few calories or some fat grams or carbs. Okay, after the crust is made, then we can make a filling that will go in the crust. That filling starts out with 3 8-ounce bars of cream cheese, and you'll see that they are softened. I have had them at room temperature probably 3 or 4 hours. It doesn't necessarily take that long always, but I wanted to make sure that they would be to the point where they could be whipped with a beater. I'm going to add in some sour cream. This is 1/4 cup of sour cream. You'll notice a lot of proteins in this dish, even though it's a dessert. And you will notice there are few carbs. Now I'm going to mix these together with this mixer. You can put more in, but it is a little difficult when you have different types of foods that you're trying to beat together. So let's just get this one taken care of and then we'll move on. I'm ready to start adding in some of these flavors, like the chocolate. So the 1/2 cup of cocoa goes in. We'll be beating this in a few minutes, but might as well get some more flavors, like the vanilla extract. That's 1 tablespoon. And then we have eggs. Being liquid, it will blend better to put all of these liquids instead of just having what we started out with and adding only one at a time. But we'll get this done, and once it's finished, we'll come back and get the last ingredient of the batter, which is our sweetener. So here we go. We're ready to sweeten our batter, and here I have it. It's artificial sweetener, and what I've chosen is Splenda. I have 3 1/2 cups of Splenda. And I'm going to pour this in, probably just half of it or so. It wants to just kind of explode into the air, and you'll be breathing it. So if you can put a little at a time in, it will be better for your purposes. You can even mash some of this in so it won't have that ability to fly away. But when you get it the way you want it, just start your mixer and keep doing that until you incorporate this 3 1/2 cups of Splenda into your batter. So here's what our batter looks like. It needs a little scraping down around the edges, and what I plan to do is to put it on top of our prepared crust, so to speak, walnuts. So we'll just get this together a little bit, and we'll be putting it lightly so that it won't move those walnuts around. And we'll continue to until we have all of the batter into the pan. Our cheesecake is ready to go in the oven. But first I'm going to put a square of aluminum foil over the top. The reason for having this foil is we will have the oven at a pretty high temperature. It'll be at 400 degrees for a while. So we're going to leave this on and prevent any burning on the top while it's in for the first 10 minutes. So this will be 10 minutes and then we'll make a change. My timer just went off, so that means the cheesecake has been in the oven for 10 minutes at 400 degrees Fahrenheit. So we're going to reduce the temperature to 300 degrees Fahrenheit and we're going to let it bake 10 minutes more. My timer went off again, and that means I need to open the oven door and reach and get the corner of the foil and take a look at how the cake is coming along. You can see a little bit of browning around the edges. That's what you expect. Now we leave the foil off of the oven door, and we keep this at 300 degrees Fahrenheit, and we're going to let it continue to cook for 20 minutes. We have our light chocolate cheesecake out of the oven. You can see it right here, and you can see a couple of splits there. It will crack and split and settle. You can probably see around the edges as I talk. It's getting a few little grooves coming in, but that's the nature of cheesecake, so don't be alarmed when that happens. What we're going to do is let this sit at room temperature until it is cool enough that we can put it in the refrigerator, because it's going to stay there until it gets completely to the temperature it should be served at. I thought I would taste test the light chocolate cheesecake for you, and you'll notice that I've decided to put strawberry slices on top. It makes it a little more appealing if you look at the colors involved in the dessert and decide which colors and flavors would go with it, and when you're forming your drink, perhaps go along with that plan. Here at the tip will be an easy bite for me to get. I say easy because this is frozen. What I normally do when I finish cooling the cheesecake, if I don't have an immediate reason for using it, then I just go ahead and wrap it thoroughly with aluminum foil and put it in the freezer. But I do cut it in wedges first, and I separate those a little bit. Otherwise, you can't cut it when it is frozen. Otherwise, you may thaw it, put it in the refrigerator, and serve it that way immediately at any time you want it. If you want to serve it frozen like this, it would be better to let it sit for a few minutes. There we go. It's really good when it's frozen. Not that it's bad the other way, but it's a very good taste, and a good taste for being chilled or frozen. I hope you enjoy it.